Hey, I'm Nick Mitchell from FXG, today reporting from Fernland University for a special class, FOV Problem. Start with FOV, field of view. This is how much you can see, what you can see. Human's field of view is about 135 degrees horizontal and 180 degrees vertical. This is just everything that you can see. Right now, this is inside my FOV. I can see it, even though I'm not looking at it, I can still see it. Here, it's out of my FOV. I can no longer see it. Currently, VR headsets on the market, they're almost all of them above 100 degrees FOV. And this is about to here. So some people, they call it a goggle effect, where you can't see everything. So if in your VR, something that's happening on this side, you're not going to see it. So let's do a little bit of an example. Something here, let's say we got a little guy right here, he's in the middle of your FOV, you're going to see him perfectly, completely, wonderful, no problems. Let's say he moves to the side, to the edge of your FOV. If he's over here, you can't see him at all. But if he's on the edge of your FOV, so let's say he's right here, this little guy, you're going to just see half of him. But the way it's going to look here is he's on the edge of your vision and you see half of him and the side is just nothing. So it's as if your eyes kind of, you have blinders on, you could say. This is a problem. As FOV gets bigger, of course it's going to be a better experience, but it's not a huge problem. Just whatever you're seeing, you just have blinders on. I can only see things in here. I have a blockage from this side. I won't be able to see anything outside of that. It's okay. We can get by. Bigger problem with FOV comes down when we talk about AR glasses. First, the problem with AR glasses is the FOV currently available on AR glasses is all lower than the FOV available on VR glasses. Now, Nreal Light has the highest FOV on the market with 52 degrees, but still, it's a small part of your vision. So you're looking at about here that you're going to see. Anything outside of here, you're not going to see. Another problem, though, with the AR headset is your virtual FOV is here, but that combines with your real-life FOV, which is, as I said, the entire surrounding area. Problem with this, let's say again we have something on your vision, we're going to draw it in here. This is approximately our FOV on your vision. Again, we have a little guy, he's over here. He's standing right there, no problem. He's inside your FOV, you're just going to see him as if he's right there in space, in augmented reality, right there. If he's outside of your FOV, again, not a big problem, you're just not going to see him. So, potentially in your design or something, if there's supposed to be a guy there that you're supposed to be aware of, or an object that you're supposed to be aware of, you're just not going to see it. So that's a problem from design. But from the viewer, it's just as if he doesn't exist. If he moves out of that space, maybe he's behind me, maybe he's on the right of me, maybe he doesn't exist anymore, he's just gone. But the experience right now, looking here, it's not going to be a bad experience, you're just going to see nothing. Personally, what I think the biggest problem with FOV on AR headsets is going to be when you have an object that is right here. So again, we got our guy, he's standing right here. You are going to see half of him. So that means in your vision, you just won't see this half. In VR, when he's over here, again I just see half of him. But it's as if the other half of him is just outside of my field of view. It's outside of my vision. Because when you're in a VR headset, the VR headset becomes your field of vision. My current wide-angle human field of vision is now canceled down in VR, and this is just my field of vision, so he's out of my field of vision, because my field of vision is equal to my VR field of vision, the limited field of vision. In the AR glasses, it's not the same. It's your field of vision is still the full situation around you, but your virtual field of vision is this small position. So that means I see him here, and I still see the rest of the world around me, but I don't see the other half of him. So for some reason, he's just cut in half. It's not as in VR. In VR, he's outside of my vision. I just can't see him anymore because he's too far away. But in AR, He's not too far away. He's right here. He should be right here, but I can only see half of him. And that's when you'll see really clearly in AR headsets, it's like a box that you see. And you see a line where your objects are and where they just disappear. That's a bad experience.
I'm back. Inside the head of the characters.
So how do we deal with this? One, we make a higher FOV. I'm sure Nreal is working on it. I'm sure every AR headset's working on it. That's a goal in the future, that your augmented FOV will be as big as your human FOV. You don't have the luxury of VR where you actually cut down your human FOV, so you don't notice this problem. So you're going to have to create an FOV of 135 degrees horizontal and 180 degrees vertical in order to beat this problem. So that's not coming soon. So how can we deal with this problem while it still exists? My concept is to design for the FOV, if that makes sense. So look at something again, like I said, inside the FOV. If the entire object is inside the FOV, again, if his head is here, but his body comes down to here, what are you going to see? You're going to see the top half of his body, and once it comes down to the bottom, his body is just cut off. So that doesn't work. We need our objects, the entirety of our objects, to stay in the middle of the FOV, and the border, as we call it, will disappear. The border only appears when your object is half on and half off. So how can we design something that is always inside? If we can take this problem that hardware has not yet fixed yet and design around it so that we don't see this problem, what would that look like? Let's go to Unity.
All right, welcome to my Unity project. I just took the Nreal demo, Hello World, and just edited it. So originally that demo has the Nreal logo and the plane detector. I didn't need either of those, so I got rid of them. As well as the Nreal input, I got rid of that too. You can see if we're demoing it, it'll show up here, the buttons and stuff. I didn't want any buttons or anything to distract from my experience, so I also got rid of the Nreal input. I think I could have just made it invisible, but I just disabled it to be easy. The main thing I did, which I think is really simple, for my central camera, I can delete the logo to start. I just added a sphere here, and I just set the bird, once it achieves a certain distance away from the sphere, to turn towards and fly towards a sphere and play the flying animation. And then once it's close enough, then to just play a normal idle flying animation. I guess then I can see. And I just began it with a company logo just to show what I have. Just a company logo. So there, and then it disappears when the bird arrives. Using the emulator, again, if I hold space, I can turn. Emulator is great. And if I go forward, it'll run away from me. If I go back, it'll chase after me. And no matter how fast I go, it always follows me. And it actually, the faster I go, the faster it will fly. So it is possible to leave the FOV if you go super, super, super crazy fast, but unless somebody's specifically testing it to try and find that, jerk your head, then you will leave the FOV. But in general, comfortable head movements, this bird is always going to stay in your field of vision, and I think offer a pretty immersive experience because we don't allow for the FOV experience breaking. Let's see how it looks like in the headset. Thank you.
Okay, so you saw it. That's how we can do, by keeping my object inside, and by somehow designing a story around it, by planning it, by thinking of what could fit. In mine, it's a bird, which makes sense. Anywhere you go, he's going to be in your positioning. But there's so many other ways you could do it. Another idea I thought of maybe around your FOV is some kind of laser. So it's not the invisible border of your FOV, but it's an actual visible laser that goes around here. So we have a laser that's augmented there, and when you go to the edge to turn off an object, your laser destroys the object. Then that fits, because then it's something that you've designed and that you've planned for that fits with it, but it's not breaking and it doesn't destroy your experience. Just another idea of how you could design for your project that an object disappearing isn't because the FOV of the headset. An object leaving your view is because of somehow of what you programmed it to be. Or maybe as you're about to leave the FOV, right when it hits the edge, it disappears. Again, then you won't see the FOV. I don't know. I don't know what could be done. You just saw my attempt to do something that will deal with this problem. I'd love to see any other ideas that you have. Share them. Send a comment. You can contact me directly. Really love to hear what you're up to. For my students, Nikk at fxg.space. Right there, you can send me a message if you have any more questions, if you want to discuss things further. But thank you so much. I've been Nikk Mitchell. Thank you, FXG, for supporting me and for supporting this tutorial. A big thanks to Nreal Light, a wonderful AR headset that's really exciting me and inspiring me as a developer. Thank you very much to our hardware partner, Oris. Not just a gaming brand, but an awesome, awesome brand for content creators to help us have the tools that we need to create awesome content. Of course, Frederick, a friend to us all. See you next time. This has been Fernland University, Nikk Mitchell, FXG, the FOV problem. See you next time.